So, here's the problem. I make video games on a desktop computer. I also use it for more general work and pretty much everything I do. But I'm traveling to Scotland this fall to study at uni. Now, I don't live in the UK, and shipping services from the US to, well, pretty much anywhere international does not bode well. And while I could hypothetically get away with just my laptop for this season, I mean, I actually did make my last published game exclusively on my laptop while in a cafe. I wanted to work on bigger projects. So, I decided to take matters into my own hands. This is how to fly with a PC overseas. The first thing we're going to want to do is prep our PC for travel. Your desktop computer is full of components that are only held on by plastic clips and contain a lot of fragile circuit boards with valuable information stored all over them. This means we need to remove them if we want any hope of our data surviving the journey abroad. Firstly, I'm not a computer expert, I'm not a professional, and I'm not recommending to do what I did. With that being said, I'm going to remove my hard drive, RAM, and GPU. You could potentially disconnect everything from your power transformer as well, as it's a really heavy component, but I'm not going to. Right now, we're just protecting our fragile components, but later, we're going to be fighting our airline's weight limit. Anyway, I started with my hard drive disk. Now, my brilliant plan was to wrap everything in bubble wrap. A lot of bubble wrap. After giving my hard drive a good old couple wraps, I wrapped it all in packing tape. Next up was the GPU. Again, some fragile components in here, but nothing is as valuable as the hard drive, because that actually contains information. But I gave it the same bubble wrap treatment because I didn't want a $100 accident. Last was the RAM. Now, with all computer clips, they kind of get stuck because of lack of use and dust buildup, so you have to be careful everything fully disconnects. You can kind of see how this one's still hanging on a little. The last thing you'd want is to fight with your valuables and accidentally break them. RAM 1 and RAM 2. By this point, you know the drill. Which finally leaves our big boy. It's just like wrapping a present. It's just a present.
Attendance and app, it's just a
present,
man.
It's a present. Honestly, I'd be pretty comfortable tucking that off of a train.
Boom, PC.
Yeah. From here, you'll need one Harry Potter Lego box set or equivalent. I cut these strips of cardboard at about an inch high to fold up and put underneath my computer to give extra cushion and lift it off of the ground. In flight, bags are stacked, and I didn't want my PC to crack under the weight of other bags. In between these strips of cardboard, we can actually sneak in some rolled up clothes. Now, clothes are pretty dense, so be careful not to pack too much in with your PC. I'd even make sure to weigh your bag before you add weight, this way you can know how much spare room you actually have. And finally, our PC is safely secured in our checked bag, and our extreme valuables safe with us on board the flight. Well, as safely as we can get them. When you check in your bag, getting a fragile sticker can't hurt, but I've read it doesn't actually change how employees treat your bag, unless the bag itself is an instrument case or something obvious, so don't bank on it. Then, it's unpacking time. You can see there's a bit of chipping on the corners here. I didn't space my computer far enough from the wheel wells. And actually, if you look closely, you can see the TSA opened my bag and left a note that says, like and subscribe, huh? That's weird. Other than that, the important bits made it through and valuable lessons were learned. If you have any questions, write them down below. I'm also curious as to what other people's experiences with this have been like. I couldn't find much online about the topic.
In a little small space, while it's still, for example, if this is about to fall out, you could easily just put the clothes in and that would stop it from falling out. So pack it jam tight with clothes.
Anyway, I have a big exam coming up, but I'm going to try and work in between studying. I'll make another video covering some more for devlog updates, but for now, I'll keep you all in suspense.